Alrighty, time for match number four here. We're 2-1. Would like to play first. Well, I'm going to keep this hand. I'm going to hope my bird does not die, because if my bird dies, then well, it's not going to end well for me. That loss to Boggles, grrr. Especially since I think this deck is pretty decent against Boggles, given that it has a couple Lilianas, has some abrupt decays for the enchantments, Damnation, then it has reasonably fast gifts. Forest Aethervile? Alright, well, let's go Liliana plus one, I guess. Get this Unburial Rites out of here. Forest Aethervile. What's going on? What am I playing against here that has Forests and Aethervile in it? Oh, right, the Hate Bears deck. And my opponent had a Woodleaf Leash. Alright, that's actually just justice. Forest Aethervile should be enough of a hint for me to know that I should not be plussing Liliana. So, that is just, yeah, that is just my bad. Alright, what are we viling in? Noble and hitting me for five? I guess probably just killing Liliana, I would imagine. She didn't really need to vile the Noble. Alright, well, see if I draw a land. I do draw a land, so I can play Gifts. I guess I cast it now, since I don't want to get destroyed by Mind Sensor or Voice. So let's get Elesh Norn. Well, what am I going to Gifts into play? Is it going to be Elesh Norn or is it going to be an Iona? I think it's actually going to be Iona and Lingering Souls. I'm just going to get those two because I already have them Barrel Rites in my graveyard here. I'm going to take a bunch of damage, but had I not plus one to Liliana there, I might have been in okay shape this game. But, oh well. Look, what can you do? Besides, like, take the time to figure out what Forest Aethervile means, which obviously I could have understood instead of doing the thing that I did. All right. Loxodon, Smitre, land. So if I can even go to eight, block, block. All right. Let's get a, wait, I go to six. Yeah, I guess that's fine. Temple Garden. And then I get to block the two biggest things and go to one here. And I'm naming white so I can't get Swords to Plowshares, rather Path to Exiled. If my opponent can vile something in, I'm dead. They did not vile anything in. Technically, they're not just crushing me here. Alright, they sack the Horizon Canopy. I like that. I mean, what's my opponent's attack? Attack with everything? And they lose Wiltleaf Liege? Oh, they attack with both. I like this. I'd much rather them attack with both than just attack with Smiter. If they just attack with Smiter, I have to block with birds because of the Noble Hierarch. But if they attack with both, then I can go snap off the Iona, block, and then take four off the Voice down to two. So I can flashback Lingering Souls, or I can cast a Bring to Light for green, black, white, blue. I can cast it for five if I tap my bird, four if I do not. Kind of like casting it for five and getting a Thrag Tusk here. That sounds pretty good. If my opponent has a Mind Sensor, then that's bad for me, but what can you do, right? Well, they did not have a Mind Sensor, so let's just get El Thragarino. This puts me to seven. Gives me some decent blocks. Let's not attack. I think if my opponent viles in a Smiter, then attacking there would have been really bad. Look at that. Well, I can't really say look at that. I made this game close when it just didn't need to be close at all because of the Liliana plus winning. But other than that, I'm actually still kind of winning. So, hey, you know. Take that for what you will. Alright, so now let's just chump with Thrag Tusk. Unfortunately, I don't have Unburial Rites left, otherwise that would be pretty sweet. I could snapcaster Gifts. That actually sounds pretty good. Let's just pass the turn. At this point, I'm assuming my opponent doesn't have a Mind Sensor. I could plays if they did. Alright, let's cast Snapcaster Mage. Oh yeah, right. Voice. Yeah. Look, I'm making this a little harder on myself than I need to. Let's just put it that way. Well, I might actually just have to end up casting Damnation at some point. But we'll see. Alright, let's cast Gifts. Give my opponent another token here. Could also get Maelstrom Pulse. Let's see, Eternal Witness, Pulse is pretty good. Just solving the problem I created somehow. There's also Soul-Tide Charm kills Aethervile, then my opponent really can't play too many more creatures, but they could play Scavenging Instant, which would be annoying. There's Elesh Norn, which I could actually just cast, right? I'm one mana short. There's Glenlinja Archmage, which doesn't do a ton. Bring to Light, I don't know about that. Oh, don't actually love most of my options here. Learnate Path. So what about Path, Pulse, Eternal Witness, and the problem is I'm just not going to, you know, no matter what, do I end up having to cast Damnation? How bad is that for me? That is pretty bad if I have to cast Damnation. Hey, well, playing great and getting rewarded is sure something. Spring to Light. Doesn't really appeal to me right now. Let's see. Archmage doesn't do a whole lot for me. What if I did cast Damnation? So I have 6 mana. I'll end up with 5 mana total. Because I could get Path Witness, Pulse, then something like Gifts or Bring to Light. I still have Lingering Souls in my graveyard as well. Could get Soul-Tide Charm, which would destroy Aethervile. Let's see. Fortunately, I really do wish I just had Unburial Rites left here. That would make things a lot easier. Could also get not get like Witness or Pulse and just get Bring to Light, but that does not seem spectacular. Alright. Don't love the way this is shaping up. I actually think I just get Gifts as the last card. This would be a lot easier if I did not let my opponent's voice trigger multiple times. Look, just because I got punished by Woodleaf Leech and Voice of Resurgence drastically does not necessarily mean I could have done anything differently. Except that's absolutely false and I could have played very differently. Okay, I love getting Gifts. People always put Gifts in the graveyard. Oh, that is nice. Alright, so let's get Eternal Witness. Drew Sylvan Caryatid. Let's get Pulse. Well, let's just solve the problem we created. Lovely. Truly lovely. Alright. And let's not have that happen again. Pass the turn. So now what? Now we chump the Smiter. But soon we can path that Wiltleaf Liege and make it less of an issue. Why does it keep doing that? That is insane. Alright, Life Malum. Alright, that's actually not that bad. So if I'm gonna path life. And let's get these back. So I think I do actually path the Wiltleaf Liege. Do it now. And now I get to start attacking with Iona. And try to end this game. And then let's go Sylvan Caryatid. Land and Lingering Souls. Right. And I don't want to flashback or dredge Life Malone next turn, I don't believe. Alright, Smiter coming in. El Smitre. Actually block with Sylvan Caritude. I've got a lot of mana. And don't think I need to worry about that. Ooh, Inquisition. Let's see what my opponent is working with. A bunch of white cards. They can tick up Woodleaf Liege to 4 here. Or to 8 of Isle of 4 to get Woodleaf Liege into play. Alright, let's just take the voice, I guess. It doesn't. I guess because you can vial that one in. Alright, so my opponent's actually pretty dead here. Because I'm going to hit with the Yuna. Doesn't change the clock, so I'm just going to hit with the Yuna and that's it. And then pass the turn. Vial ticks up to 4, which actually might put my opponent on no outs. Because now they can't even draw Unaven Mind Sensor. Nah, they probably don't have that in the main deck, though. But if they did have Mind Sensor, then they couldn't draw it. They could no longer draw that. Alright. Block. Block. Vial in the Woodleaf Liege. Alright, well, this deck must be great then if I got to put my opponent's Woodleaf Liege into play on turn 2 and then trigger Voice Resurgence multiple times. So, let's go to sideboarding here. Leon Arbiter is annoying. I will give it that. There's not much I actually like here. I mean, Explosive sounds fine. Sigard is just like a big dorky flyer. I guess, like, Thoughtseize isn't great. Inquisition's okay. I think Lingering Souls is good. Lilian is pretty awful. I guess Timely Reinforcement's probably playable. I could put in Stony Silence, even though I'm boarding on Explosives, to kill Vials. Could be decent. I could also put in Dispel. Well, this is fine. Alright, I'm going to keep this hand. This hand is pretty great. It's got turn 2 Lingering Souls, or, depending on what my opponent does, Timely. My opponent will get into 6 here, and no turn 1 Vial. Let's take 2 damage here. First of all, I don't know what I want to sack these Heaths for yet, even though I assume they're both going to be like maybe Godless Shrine plus Temple Garden. But second of all, I kind of want to take damage here, because I want to be able to go to 17 and cast a Timely Reinforcements. Alright, well, let's do that then, shall we? Let's just get 8 planes. Alright, and this ought to buy me some time here against Scavenging Ooze. No foil Horizon Canopy? Ksh, come on, not even impressed. My opponent's going to smash with a 4-4 Scavenging Ooze here. Voice of Resurgence. Probably just take it. Oh man, I'm going to have a turn 5 Illishnorn. That's going to be nice. Let's see. I guess Tectonic Edge could hold me back for a turn. Ooh. Alright, well, in that case, let's play a bird. And on my opponent's upkeep, I'm probably going to sack this Windswept Heath. Well, do I want to. I don't really even want to. Basically, I'm worried about a Mind Sensor. I think I'm just going to pass. I'm not going to. If my opponent. Okay. Now let's do it. So let's sack Windswept Heath. Let's get Godless Shrine. And let's decay the Scavenging Ooze. Scavenging Ooze is just an annoying card to have in play. I didn't want to get Mind Sensor, but since my opponent drew off Canopy, that was good. And I didn't want to trigger Voice, because, well, we've been down that road. It's not a pleasant place to be. I'm really hoping my opponent doesn't Tech Edge me next turn. Woodleaf Liege. Alright. Yeah, I'll probably chump. 6 is too much. Because next turn I'm going to go Lingering Souls, flash it back. Ooh, Caryatid. Alright, yeah, let's definitely play Caryatid. So actually, let's not even play a land so I can't get Tech Edged here. This is perfect. Because now next turn I can just play land Illishnorn. I guess it doesn't wipe my opponent's board as much as it would have previously, but it's still pretty good. Oh. I kind of don't want to double block. I think I just take a bunch of damage here. Because Next turn, the nobles are just going to die to Elishnorn. Brimaz, King of Oriskus. Well, I don't really want to play Damnation. What is one card in hand? It would be kind of bad if it was a Path to Exile, I'm not going to lie. It's just attack in the air. I don't really want to die if I get pathed here. Basically, if my opponent doesn't have path, they're in a lot of trouble. So, I don't really see a reason to play such that they do. Alright, Smiter. Ooh, Gifts Ungiven. Interesting. What can I gifts for right now that's good? If I gifts for a way to kill Will Leafleash, I can get like... I have the Lingering Souls in my graveyard too. Okay. But I can get like Path, Maelstrom Pulse, Snapcaster Mage that already kills Will Leafleash. That'll kill Voice, but then the Voice token will still live. Let's just attack in the air for 6, put my opponent to 6. Flashback Lingering Souls, and leave up Gifts just in case I need to reevaluate if something happens here. Alright, we did it. 3-1, so one more match to see if we can finish with a pretty good record despite some comical misplays in this particular match.